Of all the vivid and entertaining characters that Mowgli meets on his journey back to the Man Village, one character never made it past the storyboard stage. Rocky the Rhino was described by Walt Disney in story meetings as a sort of Mr. Magoo of a rhinoceros, half blind and extremely dumb. Writer Larry Clemens and his story team spent a year developing Rocky and the sequence in which he would star. The fight with Mowgli at the Black Pool, the Vulture's Lair. The choice for Rocky's voice was Frank Fontaine, best known for his recurring character Crazy Guggenheim on the Jackie Gleason Show. With Fontaine's distinctive voice, Rocky had all the makings of another standout personality in the Jungle Book cast.
That's what friends are for.
Walt and his story team kept striving for more personality for the vultures, who evolved from typically scruffy vultures into the four Liverpudlian mop tops inspired by British invasion bands of the time. They continued to struggle with the storyline, with Walt wanting the vultures to be more active in the sequence to stir things up. This series of storyboards starts with the vultures mentioning their friend, Rocky.
Who's Rocky?
One vulture instructs Mowgli he needs to have a better vantage point.
Just climb up there. You'll see Rocky. I'm not afraid of Rocky. Say that again, just once more, so my little ear can hear it a bit louder. I said I'm not afraid of Rocky. Who said he ain't afraid of Rocky? He did.
I'll clobber him.
Don't worry, kid, he ain't got all his marbles.
Marbles? I have too got all my marbles, just listen. Big ones, ain't they?
What I tell you? Besides, he's as blind as a bat.
I smell a man cub. Where is he? Hey, Beaky, point me in his direction, will ya?
I'm right in front of you.
Hiding behind that post, huh?
Rocky draws a line in the sand, and soon everyone is daring Mowgli to cross it. Mowgli's not interested, but one of the vultures solves that problem. Rocky starts gearing up for some action. And the vultures get ready for the show they've been waiting for. A clueless Rocky asks what happened, and the vultures inform him that there's going to be a round two to this fight.
Go pick up the pieces. Rocky, the new fella punched Rocky right off the scene. Come on, mates, let's go meet the new champ. Kid, we'd like to make you an honorary vulture.
Mowgli declines their invitation, declaring that he is a person with no friends. The dialogue here is quite similar to the final film, but it leads to a very different result. Walt initially suggested that the vultures sing their song in the style of the Beatles. The song was never fully finished, but several audio tracks were discovered that give a very good indication of the direction they were going.
We're your friends.
They're your friend.
We're your friends to the bitter end.
When you're dawning, who hangs around to fuck you up when you are down? And when you're out for the count, who picks you up off the floor?
That's what friends are for.
And when you're lost, in dire need, he's at your side, at lightning speed. And when you're outside looking in, who's there to open the door?
That's what friends are for.
You know the zebra, the hyena, and the kangaroo. The cobra and the lion all agree it's true. We're fond of every creature coming down the pike.
In fact, they never met an animal they didn't like.
Who offers near? Who are your chums? Prepare to pounce when danger comes. Who's always eager to extend a friendly claw?
That's what friends are for.
You know the armadillo, elephant, and wild boar.
The cheetah and the anteater, they adore.
We eat
and dine with the rhino and his shiny spike.
In fact, they never met an animal they didn't like.
So you can see,
oh yeah,
we're friends in need,
oh yeah,
and friends in need,
oh yeah,
are friends indeed,
oh yeah.
We'll keep you safe in the jungle forevermore. That's what friends are for.
At a certain point in development, Walt decided to abandon this rock version of the Vulture song and replaced it with the barbershop quartet that appears in the final film.
We're your friends. We're your friends. We're your friends to the bitter end.
The bitter end.
In the end, it was Rocky the Rhino who needed a friend. Walt was growing uncertain about the character. Some people believe it was because Walt didn't find Fontaine's voice so funny after listening to it for months on end. But as Walt said in a story meeting in January of 1966, there are too many action sequences in a row. The monkeys, the vultures, and Rocky are all ugly. There's no balance. Maybe we could drop Rocky. And with that, Rocky's short-lived film career came to an end.